Good morning, everyone. I'm glad to be here, period. My first time in a year. But I'm glad to be here to give an update from the COVID team. First, I want to tell you that we have all been so encouraged by the unexpected speed of the vaccine production in our nation and in the steady progress of getting those shots into arms. And we find ourselves back in this lovely, holy season that once prompted Martin Luther to say, "Our Lord has written the promise of resurrection, not in books alone, but in every leaf of springtime." Everything seems so right, and it's very tempting to think, we can go back to normal. We can loosen those reins a bit. But to this impulse, I offer a current and less poetic quote from our nation's top medical advisor, who said this month, "Don't spike the ball on the 5-yard line. We are heading in the right direction, but it is too soon to be declaring victory." The COVID committee is heeding the consensus of medical advice because our first priority is to protect you, this congregation, from harm. We resumed our services this year with best practices, and we will hold on tight to them until we are advised to do otherwise. So we don't want to lose any of the treasured progress we've made. We've worked so hard and so long, and now we are really close. Best practices, as a quick review, is wearing masks, taking temperatures, washing hands and sanitizing hands, observing social distancing by limiting our number to what can safely be accommodated in the sanctuary, and ushering worshipers to and from their seats. It is in anticipation of Easter joy, I'm happy to announce that we will have two services next week in the sanctuary at 8:30 and 11. The 8:30 service will accommodate 225 people because our choir will not be performing its full Easter program, opening up our balcony seating. At 11, our choir will take up the balcony, so we can only accommodate 125 people. Communion will be served at both services. We will also have an overflow room in our gym where we can worship safely together as the service is live streamed, and communion will be served there as well. And one last thing, be sure you hear this, reservations as usual for both services will be needed and can be made online or by calling the church office. In fairness to everybody, reservations will not be taken before tomorrow morning, March 29th. And I will leave you with one piece of good, no, I'd say great news. The 8:30 service will resume on a regular basis on April 18th, 3 weeks from today. God is good. His mercy is everlasting. On behalf of the COVID team, I pray that everyone here physically and everyone with us virtually will have a holy journey this week as we travel through the cross to the resurrection hope and assurance that waits on the other side. Thank you.